It's Thanksgiving week. That was so fake. Like, I didn't need to be up at 6:30. I just couldn't sleep. Like, I didn't set my alarm to get up and do productive shit. People make videos where they, like, set their camera up to slap their fucking phone when their alarm goes off. The opposite of what I just did. I went up, got my camera, clicked the phone, saw what time it was, and was like, fuck my life. But it's Thanksgiving week, and there's a lot of work to do. So very little time. It's Tuesday, which is good, because Monday is usually my most hectic day. And we got that out of the way already. It's gonna be a long fucking day. Fade the Public boys and Steve are coming over. We're making something ignorant for Thanksgiving. We have a Thanksgiving episode this week. So we're gonna be doing some cooking at the HQ. Tomorrow, we got a Friendsgiving at Steve's in Jersey. And Thursday, my mom's coming into Brooklyn. We're going to my sister's apartment for an actual Thanksgiving. So I have like 7 Thanksgivings in a row. Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday. No one is that fucking thankful. I'm not that thankful. But I'm thankful for you. Thankful for every one of you that's watching right now. So, welcome to thy vlog.
Finally famous, nigga.
Hung up in your love, baby.
Yeah.
Under your spell.
Good.
Now higher and higher.
Yeah.
Everything
good. Shine down.
Under your spell.
Okay, I get lost in the night. Faded off of that brown. We could take shots of that white.
Beans, creams, potatoes, tomatoes, lamb, ram,
pork,
beans, creams, potatoes, tomatoes, chicken, turkeys, rabbit.
You name it.
Beans, creams, potatoes, tomatoes, lamb, ram, pork, beans, creams, potatoes, tomatoes, chicken, turkeys, chicken, turkeys, beans, creams.
You gotta press record if you want to.
The best story that never was. That's what just happened.
You have no idea what just happened.
I don't know
here.
What just happened.
Mac, what are you doing?
Making the plate for all the nachos.
Why didn't you just use a plate?
What? He just thinks stupid. He doesn't understand that you can just go and put this in the microwave.
Yeah, that's fine. That's
put
fine.
Two chefs in a kitchen together.
Isn't there a saying like that?
How much water are you boiling?
You got two quarterbacks, you got no quarterbacks.
Exactly.
So this is like a Nick Foles, Mitch Trubisky situation.
Yeah.
Who is the head chef here anyway? Who's the head chef? Someone needs to take charge.
This is on. This is on.
Yeah, turn it on.
The fact that neither of them are calling it means they don't want
it. That's like a high pop in the outfield.
Trying to figure it out.
No one has the balls to say my mind.
This is all they would give me.
You're supposed to pay for it.
I did it. Charged me 50 cents. I said, oh, well, can I have a couple more? I said, I'll go, I'll give you.
We're going to end up making a pizza, and we're going to end up...
I'm just going to end up eating peanut butter out of the jar. That's what this is going to end up being. Appreciate the effort, though.
What is that for?
Okay, so...
What is happening?
Every time
that's bullshit.
That's not nachos.
I want to slap somebody with that so bad.
You?
No.
Slow-mo slap.
Yeah, slow-mo slap would be good.
Across the face, my friend. It just got slapped. Yes, that really just happened.
Happy Slapsgiving, everybody.
Has he ever cooked a day in his life?
I think he's made toast. Good buttered toast.
I might start dipping the chips in the peanut butter right now. Fuck it.
Whoa, whoa, whoa. Yeah?
Because these taste so good and that overwhelming.
You don't need it. You gotta try one of these.
What's that?
No,
like OBJ in his prime.
It's your turn.
About what?
Open your mouth. Long range.
That's what she said.
That was good. How many slices? That was like 4.
Okay. Yeah. No, Steve, we're gonna do like the old...
We're gonna do like the machine?
Yeah.
And what the fuck was that?
Should I throw it overhand so it's directly to your mouth, or you
just
want to go?
Throw it at my mouth. Okay, I don't care how you do it.
Okay.
Where'd that hit you?
Right in the eye. Still take bro.
I'm gonna do like a flip up.
Oh, that's not
good.
That was a broken skull waiting to happen.
Are separate? I always put the taco seasoning in the water. Yeah.
Do you know how hard it is?
It feels like you're just eating like salty baby food.
That is not stuffing.
Do you know how hard it is to fuck stuffing up?
Dude, it's fucking stovetop from the
what
box.
Did you do to think I like made this?
It is disgusting.
It comes in a bag.
I thought it was pretty good, to be honest.
Making the Thanksgiving one right now. Getting the turkey on there. Nah, you can get it on there. It's all good. He's got a wide angle lens there. Steve's doing the Mexican style nacho. Get these nasty ass.
Yo, I love mashed potatoes on my chips.
Mashed potatoes.
That's fucking so vile. You couldn't pay me to eat that.
I'm not talking. No, you'll see.
I got the stuffing coming in right now. Give it one more last.
Hold on, let me just get a video of this before you screw it up.
Oh yeah, you gotta put the cheese on it.
I mean, like, those don't actually look that bad.
Because they're the only real nachos on the fucking table.
Pizza.
You sample it?
Yeah, somewhere between Lunchables and Dollar Slice.
That's
it's not bad.
Do you want to do this?
I want to start with the intro.
That's absurd. You're going to put me out. I hear you. You just want to start with the intro.
In.
Dick, you guys like him. You like him on YouTube. He's a great guy to you guys. He doesn't know what he's doing. He can't even tuck a shirt right.
Bag on. So, blah, blah, blah. Welcome to the show. And we do our spiel. Adam lost again. He's clearly got the bag on his head. You know, what's cracking? And then you say, Scott, hit the intro, and it will go to the intro, and it will cut back to us eating the nachos in, like, the video form or whatever. So Ike wants to add music or slow-mo it or time-lapse, whatever. And then we just do the show. Instead of eating nachos throughout the show, crunching it, it just would be a disaster.
People like that, though. They like hearing you eat. They do. There's a whole industry built on listening to people eat. I'm an industry guy.
ASMR.
AK-47. We ready?
And we'll start how you like to start. You can't tell us what to eat. You can't tell us how to eat. Yeah, it's fun.
Start like a happy Thanksgiving. You can't do this. Like all that.
I'd like to start with last night's matchup. Well, the entire nation was captivated. Animal, clearly, we spoiled it for you. He's 0-11 now. He's going to go winless.
So that was an absolute fucking shit show. It was really fun, though. Whenever we have things to do prior to filming, Fade the Public especially, like the episode during the summer when we went to play basketball and that random drunk guy ended up playing us like 3-on-1. Anytime we do something like energetic and physical, our episodes come out fucking awesome. By the time you watch this, you probably already saw the Thanksgiving episode, which was one of my favorite episodes we've ever done. It was a mess. It was beautiful. I was so pissed because when we started the vlog, the first like 5 minutes I taped at the table, I accidentally had the camera in slow-mo, so we couldn't use that in the vlog. And then I gave the fucking camera to Stevie One Chains, and then the first like 7 minutes he recorded wasn't recording. And there was so much funny shit that happened in there, but the rest of the episode was awesome to make up for it. And now I just threw out a bunch of shit, but I have enough cheese to last me until fucking next Thanksgiving. Like, all these dudes do is eat cheese, but I'm blessed up because they left me some lami, little slams and roni. I could live off this shit. This is Animal bringing just raw broccoli for the live stream last week. I tell you what, my friends are fucking maniacs. Not in like a good way. Not in that, I didn't mean that in an endearing way. Like, oh, they're so fun. They're maniacs. Like, they're just fucking psychotic. Those nachos were terrible. Terrible, except for the dessert nachos. So I'm starving over here. I'm about to go get pizza. It's like 10 o'clock at night. I barely fucking ate today. Barely slept today. This is still the same fucking day from that 6:30 a.m. thing. Feels like 6 days. Feels like it's Thanksgiving 2021 already. My eyes hurt. I can't look at screens anymore. I'll see you at Steve's Friendsgiving tomorrow.
Thanksgiving one in the books. Fade the Public episode down. On our way to Steve's. About to get hit by a car. We're a little late.
On them bikes.
Sir?
In the hallways of my heart, cause all the blessings are somebody else's. The flowers in my neighbor's pot, I'm torn exactly into two pieces. One who wants you and one who adores, but I'm still inside. You're the fast machine, always holding your love. Across the bridge, sold my bedroom from my home. Days, these ghosts in the music, or the endless roar from the past. But while you're playing at the 90s, you're coming up anything that lasts. But I'm still inside, oh, you're a fast machine.
Always follow the Uber Eats guy. Got the electric bikes, so they get ahead of you. They hit the red lights. They go, you go. If they don't go, we still go.
There ain't no one that I can live by. Just these nagging that I can't shake. The hum coming from the basement. A little cry now for crying out's sake. If I can learn to love you, share. When your shadow hits the light, and there ain't no trace of what we've been through, then I'll shout it till the day I die. I'm still inside your fast machine. I'm away from in your love so free.
All right, so we got the train station, which
is
Madison Square Garden. For those of y'all that don't know New York, which I'm sure are a lot of you, Penn Station, which is the main train station in New York, is inside, underneath Madison Square Garden. One and the same. As you can see, New York is very far from dead. I mean, most people here are, like, we're dead prior to COVID in the street, so. Made it in record time, as you saw. I almost got hit by like 7 fucking cars. 3 bike guys. Uber guy on the bike was cool as hell. He gave a nod. I hope I got that on camera. I don't know the train schedules to New Jersey. Steve's telling me to take one train here. I'll get an Uber from there. He'll pick me up from here. Go to the Oranges. The Oranges are like wildly ghetto. I don't want to end up there. I don't know what I'm doing. What happens when you come to places late? You get later. It's an exponential. The law of diminishing returns. So I was just going to drink a White Claw like a homeless guy.
I'm just being
broccoli and stuff to make. Hello. What's
up, boys?
What's up?
Snacky has arrived to Thanksgiving. 2 nights in a row. I have to spend with this fucking
what
asshole.
What do you mean? I fucking look good tonight.
You do look you good. Do, actually, if only there were some women here.
You look way better
than me. No, it's no win. You little bitch. Are you kidding me?
This is like the first thing I did. I like got here, opened the wine, went pop.
You wear, I love that you wear just like an undershirt here.
Yeah,
I actually did too. So, yeah, it's just black, so.
Black.
Yeah.
My bestest
what's up,
friend
baby?
In the world is here.
Let's fucking go.
Rocking beautiful Keith X Steve blacked out in Times
yes,
Square
sir.
Collab t-shirt.
So you got us Philly.
You go, wait, can you walk us through your thought process for the food selection tonight? Like,
oh,
how it went from, like,
Boston
Thanksgiving, Boston Market
yeah.
to
fresh well, I was going to get Boston Market, and George was like, why Boston Market? I'm like, it's kind of like Thanksgiving-esque. And then he was just like, make a beef Wellington. And I was like, fuck you, George. So then we went to Boston Market, and the whole day I was going to get it, and I kept calling them, no one would answer.
You think they're like fucking backed up on
I think
Thanksgiving?
So. Dude, I kept
everybody's like,
I called like 4 different ones and I did Uber Eats so they like cannot meet.
Would you have gone all the way to Emerson to pick up?
Fuck no. And that's what started to happen.
I don't think I believe you, to be honest.
But then I got really lazy like after I cleaned up and everything. And I was like, hey, what do you guys feel about pizza? They're like, not mad
yeah,
about
and, like,
it. And I was
like,
you
would give a shit.
And then I
that's like the hosting move. Like act like you pretend about
buffalo chicken.
So they have an interesting choice of pizza here. They got the buff chick.
Yeah. So this is Philly with fries on it.
Whoa, whoa.
It needs to be heated
whoa,
up.
Whoa,
yeah.
whoa,
are,
whoa.
Are
whoa.
Are
is it good?
I didn't have it heated up, so it's definitely better now.
These are heated. I'm going to eat one.
I told Animal, I tell you, you know what it needs. A little ketchup.
A little ketchup on
garlic,
top.
Too.
Maybe a little garlic.
Don't put ketchup.
I don't
he
want
knows.
He
knows if I'm coming, they better bring the fucking nuts.
What we're talking about.
I'm just gonna leave it on the thing.
This is how you do Thanksgiving.
There's a problem here.
No.
Too much clunks of sauce. That's not good.
Well, he didn't make the pizza.
I didn't say he did. I'm just saying. It's just. It's...
Snack says too much clunks of sauce.
That's. I'm serious.
It's super garlicky, but it's good.
Garlicky?
Yeah.
Let's try this out.
Yeah, see, that's a perfect slice right there. Yep.
I know how to pick them.
This is hot, too.
I don't know why I'm here.
This is a good slice.
Should've just stayed home. Wow, this is really good. Yeah.
Snacks eats foods.
Let's start with Philly.
Oh, wow. The first thing you came here is Philly cheesesteak pizza.
You know what? That's fine because I just beat their cunt in.
Okay.
I beat their fucking...
What is that?
It's
the pizza sauce we didn't get last
night.
Garlic
nut?
I got it warmed up. Hold on.
So stupid.
Not really.
Steve was gonna do MTV Cribs. Then he realized that I built everything in here. This is basically the house that Perk built. The house that Nick built. Can't take this guy anymore.
What
we
the
go to Friendsgiving, he's arguing Giants versus Cowboys over here.
She started it! She came
started
up to
it.
Me!
He's like, you don't even know who's the quarterback of the Cowboys.
That's
right
not
now.
What I said. You, see, it's your house and everybody's gonna stick up for you, but you're fucking wrong.
It could be worse, you could be a Jets fan.
I mean, if
listen.
When's the comeback season?
Listen. I don't wanna talk about comeback season because I don't fucking know.
T. Lawrence,
what
baby.
I can say,
come on.
What I can say?
You know Trevor Lawrence is gonna suck.
You're not gonna be good until Gary V takes the team.
That's like 20 years.
Yeah.
Like
I didn't know. Sit it out.
Hope I'll be alive. But what I could say.
We got the boy. We got the E-Town get down boys here.
I didn't.
What he said?
He goes, we're talking about fantasy football punishments. And he goes, well, can we sacrifice? And I go, I really like the frosted tips for a month idea. And he goes, that's not even that hard. That's probably the easiest one ever. I would frost my tips right now for free.
I didn't say for free.
We've been trying to get his hair in weird ways.
Jason's an honorable man.
He
never said
free.
I almost said 0-14. Can we frost a tip you in?
No, I'm not going to do a double punishment for losing like extra.
I know.
I have to suffer through that. That's enough.
I think you should kill him.
I honestly think Brad would do that.
$5 for 12 donuts. $5 for 12 donuts.
I don't know if this is a sandwich, if this is a bagel with cream cheese. Yo, get your fingers out of my goddamn dinner. Wait, so you want to take a bite at the other end? Get in here.
I kind of want to see this motherfucker.
Let's go mouth to mouth.
Tell
them they're
creamy.
Good?
Colin,
you think it's good?
Yeah.
Do you want there's so some jelly in there?
Why you keep shoving it? Give me a knife.
Not bad. Zero qualm.
It's it tasted like a cloud.
I thought this was cheese, so I was ready to vomit. For an apple tip.
Do you know how you know you're fucking old? When your friends start accepting jelly donuts. Back, can I get a take on donuts?
On donuts?
Yeah, like overall takes, like jelly donuts, not okay, right? You actually
jelly,
donuts,
like jelly donuts suck.
Thank you.
They are.
You're gonna take the guy that puts American cheese on Cheetos and puts it in the microwave. His taste of food?
You call me snacks for a reason.
I'm gonna give some free advertising right now. Glazed Donuts. Glazed Donuts, New Milford. Go there. Thank you.
Looks like my hair.
Chick-fil-A.
Yeah, they're like a.
He's got no lips.
It literally looks like a donut with extra Chick-fil-A sauce.
Welcome back. Welcome back.
We're back in New York.
Bitch.
So we're bike. Went to Steve's for Friendsgiving. It's so funny, he worries about me like he's my fucking mom. Like he thinks I'm like malnutritious. So he's like, you don't eat enough. You don't buy enough food. He starts making fun of my fridge and shit. And then he sends me home with like a whole ass apple pie. Pizza. He gives me fucking Heath's avocados. She's big mad about that. I'm like, Steve, like. I'm actually all in. Like, I was probably the one who suggested to give me all the food. You don't eat enough. And it's probably fucking true, actually. Especially during the season when I told you. I'm trying to tell y'all. I'm on an Altoid and coffee diet only. And sometimes he gives me pizza. What kind of Zai we got here? Buffalo chick. Thanksgiving 2 in the books. Tomorrow's with the mother. And my sister. You know, sometimes I'm like, yeah, it's weird living alone. It gets lonely. It'd be kind of cool to have a roommate, someone to just like hang out with, boring at night. And then sometimes I'm like, yo, it's kind of lit living alone because. You can do things like this.
My mama came to Manhattan and picked me up. I really am in a car now. I feel like once every like 6 months. It's kind of weird. I miss driving. Came, picked me up. We're on our way to Brooklyn, to Kelbert's apartment. I haven't been to her new apartment. Is it nice?
Yeah.
Actually, or are you just being a nice mom?
No, it is. It's very nice. You'll see.
So we stopped in at the. She's gonna be angry that somehow I got Trulies instead of White Claws. They didn't have any White Claws in the CVS, so we had to pivot. Those things were like $18 for the case. What are we even eating today?
Plenty of food. There's a lot of food back there.
Quarter of a mile.
Turn right on Evans Street.
We have arrived at Kilbert's. There's a lot of firewood. Have you made a fire yet?
No, it hasn't been,
I need more plants, that's what I need.
It hasn't been like cold enough to, but they only deliver it to Manhattan because I didn't find one over here in time. If you order 15 bundles.
Where do you order it from?
This place on the Upper East Side that my friends use who live up there.
Give us a tour, Kilbert. Where's the lights at? We need even better lighting. There's a feature film production company. This is a good decoration. I like those.
Well, let me take that.
You scared me.
Right. This is my living room. Here it is. A fireplace. I haven't used it yet. I made that table.
You made that?
Not from like pieces.
Kind of looks like my coffee table.
Wood, but I stripped and like did all the varnish and stuff on
it. Did you buy this?
Yes, I bought that.
It's legit.
Tour.
Yeah.
This is a painting that I got. Oh, look at
this. From an animal did this painting.
Like, from a random person that was getting rid of it. That was from the garbage.
Big garbage guys here. A long ass hallway.
Garbage guy. These are
long hallways. We've got 10 bathrooms. We could shit all day.
It's a regular bathroom.
Whoa. It's a master bedroom.
Bedroom.
You got an office in your office?
This is my office. I'm going to paint a mural in here.
Why though?
Why what?
Because of mannequin.
Because I sew. And,
Boomstick.
Hi. Hi. My,
What's that? Is that another closet?
Utilities.
This room's so tall. How do you even get that up there?
I just threw it up there. I don't know. I'm not going to need it for a while.
Probably hit you in the head the first couple times.
Are you wearing a mask inside or what's going on? Who, me?
Should I put mine on?
You should.
Really?
Don't you think you should wear a mask?
Not almost killed.
Look at yes, us. Yes, Tessa, yeah, yeah.
I'm a big happy family.
She went up there to help Uncle Fred. Jean brought her up there in the afternoon to see the baby.
Nah, the baby's going to be all grown up before it gets to her.
Yeah.
I want to get there. I have to get there.
She's always smiling and
we
laughing.
We grew up together. We live in the same house together.
Better give your mother my best
wishes. I have four brothers.
I will. You want to laugh? The other day, we were over by Stevens, and she got her hearing aid. So we were sitting at a table, and I guess, I don't know if she got it tuned in right or whatever. She's like, why is everybody shouting? Why is everybody shouting at the table? So she just got it. I think she got finally got it from Costco or whatever.
That's what I'm wearing. I don't know if you can see, but I'm wearing.
Hey, it's a holiday. I got hoes on hoes and they out of control, yo. Hey, it's another way. All my niggas on go and I hope that you know it. I can't even close my eyes and I don't know why. Guess I don't like surprises. I can't even stay away from the game that I play. They gon' know us today, yeah. Ay, can I pop shit? I might bottom on the low, but they top shit. Switch the genre on you hoes, do a rocket. I got the biggest damn song, fuck the charts, sis. I don't need them. They wanna know if I be last done. Bitch, even if I started flopping, that be fashion. Popping up in movies, ain't no Nazi bitches ass done. Hee hee, I'm bad as Michael Jackson. Hey, it's a holiday. I got hoes on hoes, and they out of control, yo. Hey. It's another way. All my niggas on go, and I hope that you know it. I can't even close my eyes, and I don't know.
That is all, folks. That is a Thanksgiving week served up big dog style. I hope that that tasted a little bit better served up than the nachos that we made. As you can see, the Christmas tree's all done. Things are looking good. And as Mr. Bill Belichick would say, we're on to Christmas. And I just realized that y'all probably just saw the nail. It is not bruised, it is actually painted. I'm gonna give you a quick backstory on it, cause fuck it, why not? After Thanksgiving last night, I was at my sister's obviously, came bike to my abode. Ended up going to a friend's apartment, a lovely, lovely woman, a very nice lady, really big fan of her. She's fun, whatever. So fast forward, you know, a little bit of time passes. I'm at the apartment. You guys can use your imagination. You can also congratulate me in the comment section. Thank you, thank you, thank you. Afterwards starts, you know, she's painting her nails. And I'm like, this is weird. Is this like the equivalent of like the post, you know, cigarette? Like, is this the girl's version of it? I've never come across this before. And then she's like, can I paint one of your nails? People are getting more open with their style, you know, like rappers are starting to like paint their nails colors and shit. And I was like, I don't really care. Like, you know, if you really want to do it, you know, it's the least I could do for you after considering. So like, fuck it. I let her paint one of my nails. I don't give a shit. The problem is like, I want to take it off right now. But like, that was last night. Got home kind of late. Like, I went to sleep. I woke up and I'm doing this shit. I'm making the vlog. I'm editing the vlog. I'm putting out the vlog. So I haven't had time to like do anything in my life besides work. And now I have this thing and I don't know what the fuck to do with it. Like, I've never painted a fucking nail before. I don't have nail polish remover. I don't know how to get it done. Like, should I just chip away at it? Should I just keep like clawing at it? Should I fucking put some liquor in the red Solo cup and then dunk it in there? You know what's funny? I don't know if I ever told you guys the story, but in college, my senior year of college, we adopted a cat. I lived in a house with three of my friends, and one of my friends, big pothead, went out to Colorado, brought back weed. And at this time, I didn't really smoke weed anymore. By the time I was like a junior, senior in college, I stopped because I get paranoid when I smoke weed. So I just completely kind of cut it out of my life. But he brought back some weed from Colorado that was like legitimately different colors. It was like purple and blue. And I was like, fuck, like I'm not going to not smoke this. So we smoked it, got really stoned. And the lady next door, cat lady, breeds cats and she gives them away for like adoption. So we were like, oh, this is a really good idea. Like, definitely not doing this because we're really high, but let's go over and get a cat. Mind you, this was like off the dome. We didn't think about it or discuss it or plan for it or anything. So we don't have cat food. We don't have like a bed. We don't have toys. We don't have a fucking thing that has anything to do with cats. We go over there and we adopt a cat. And super cute, like amazing. And then we realize like, yeah, like cats are a living thing, you know? So you have to like take care of them. After like a couple hours, we're like, this thing is so cool. It's so cute. Like, I'm glad we did this. And then it pooped. And we're like, oh my God, like just imagine like four people that are just like really high, get a cat and then it poops and we don't know what to do because like it's supposed to have cat litter, supposed to have a place where it poops and it poops on the ground. And we're like, oh my God, how do we clean the cat? How do we clean the poop? What do we do? So my first instinct was to grab a Solo cup. I filled it up with water. This will surely clean the cat. So I take the cat, it's not face down. This is face up, obviously it's fine. I start dunking the cat's ass into the Solo cup of water to clean its ass. Thankfully, one of the guys that lived in the house with me, his girlfriend, adopted the cat afterwards because that sort of behavior, that cat would have been in a coffin within about 2 months. I chose to call the cat Bernstein. He grew up, my friends put cat litter under my bed. It kept taking shits for like a month and a half. So I eventually resented the fucking cat. Also, I have scratches on my arm and my chest still from that fucking cat. It grew its nails out, started scratching me, and till this day, big anti-cat guy. Why did I get on this? Because the nail, I'm like, do I dip the nail into liquor in the cup and then it will come off? This is just like a full scale, I also cut my hair this morning, it looks fucking terrible. A full scale karma for the, God, is this full scale karma for dunking the cat in the Solo cup in college to my finger? And this vlog got off the rails. Next vlog I put out is probably gonna be like a Christmas version of this vlog. I guess I don't like surprises. I can't even stay away from the game that I play. They gon' know us today. Man, I snuck into the game, came in on a horse. I pulled the gimmick, I admitted.